Have you ever thought about starting your own podcast? When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions. How do I record an episode? How do I get my show into all the apps that people like to listen to? And how do I make money from my podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is so very easy and simple. It is Anchor, y'all. It's Anchor. Anchor is a one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it is 100% and ridiculously easy to use. Most of all, it is free. And now, y'all, Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad here. I use Anchor for my radio broadcast as another branch to advertise and promote my episodes and my show that stems right from YouTube. And what I like about Anchor is that it distributes all to many platforms, as well as it has an in-depth statistics to where you can see how your podcast is doing. That's cool, right? I love it. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, please go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters who are already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. My name is Red, and I'm the host of the RH3 show. I cannot wait to hear your podcast. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for each and every one that is listening to me under the sound of my voice, moved by your spirit on today's broadcast. Father, Lord, we thank you for everyone that has come in contact with this broadcast. Father, touch their lives on today and any other day, Father. And Lord, we just thank you, Father, for the podcast platforms, Father, moved by your spirit, Father. Lord, touch every area, every part of the world that has been affected by this platform, this broadcast. Lord, we thank you, Father, for the radio stations, for the affiliate stations that so graciously decided to bring on the RH3 show. Lord, we just thank you that you continue to raise up somebody somewhere to use their power, their ability, and most of all, their influence to help each and every one that has in part, has their part of this radio show. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praises, because it is in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen. Y'all, it's time for the RH3 show. Let's go ahead and get this all new broadcast on today.
And now we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Switch my old status, that's from sinner to saint. As winners we can't live by the picture they paint, because they know that all the inner is changed. So we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint, which means do I live or we ain't. We are controlled by the flesh, with the feeling of sway.
My fellow people, listen. What's going on, everybody? Y'all already know what's going on. Welcome to the RH3 show. Glad to have you all. If you're new, hey, welcome. You already know who it is. If you don't know, hey, I'm your boy Red, and I'm the host of this great, 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 great program that comes on every Monday through Friday. To check the times and the local listings, please visit my website at therh3show.com. Listen, y'all, I got a lot of explaining to do. So just join me for a little kitchen table talk. Pull up your chairs. We're going to discuss it. I got a lot of explaining to do. There's a lot of hiccups happened behind the scenes on my end on yesterday. And I need to talk about it. All right. It's a little minute. But I didn't realize it until today. I'm like, oh. So, yeah. We gonna talk. Let's go ahead. It's time for the kitchen table talk. Alright, pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It's time for our kitchen table talk. Alright, y'all. It is time for the kitchen table talk. This is where we all sit around and gather and just talk and just have a good time. I got my drink. What y'all got? What y'all got? What y'all got? Let me know. Let me know. Converse with me. I'm going to put up an image on Instagram. I'm going to put up an image on Snapchat. Respond to it. Reply to it. Comment on it. I'm going to put up an image on Facebook. Facebook.com/TheRH3Show. Comment on it. And let me know what you are having during your break time. Whatever. Look, this is during our kitchen table talk. That's where we sitting down and just, you know, having our little, you know, snack discussion, whatever. Y'all having your lunch, you driving or whatever. If you're driving during the 5 o'clock hour, you know, whatever. If you're listening during on the podcast platforms and you're having to do your supper time or whatever. Just let me know what you're doing at the moment. If you breaking and you having your break or whatever. Hey, this is where we having our discussion, our time. Is this our me time or whatever? And this is our conversation. And so we discuss. Listen. Y'all, after I come on at 1 o'clock. After that 1 o'clock airing, it was a wrap. It was a Christmas present on December the 25th. It was a wrap. It was a wrap. Meaning that I took the headsets off and I dipped. I told y'all how I was feeling. I told y'all, you know, whatever. I was good on air. I was good. But I was like, okay, I'm done for the day. I'm gone. Boom. Out of here. I didn't think about no other affiliates. I didn't think about no other podcast platform. Until this morning. Oh, when I got up this morning. You know, okay, if y'all don't know, I'm going to tell y'all how I get my day started. Get up in the morning about, you know, give or take about 7-ish. If I don't oversleep, well, no, the night before, I prep. I try to go through, you know, mentally what I'm going to talk about, discuss. I may do a little rundown or do a run through, a rehearsal or whatever. I have a little show sequence paper that I look over, and sometimes I go over pre-record segments, and you know whatever, and if not, I just do a run through, and then go to sleep or whatever, you know. Be in the bed by lately I've been trying to be in the bed no later than 11:30, but lately I've been doing good. Football, try to watch it last night. I was in the bed off and on. Good. But this morning. Back to my schedule. Then I get up between 7:20 7:20, but I know I'll be up by 7:30 because my alarm is on. And then that's whenever I am listening to the Car Chronicles movement with Apostle Jamila Gooden. And she comes on at 7:30. Go search on Facebook, Jamila Gooden. And listen to her Car Chronicles movement. And so, I listen to her 7:30. And then between 7:30 and 8:10, I take, not really take a break, but I get a phone call, a personal phone call from, you know, some special people, and, you know, talk for about a good few seconds, literally. It's either a phone call or a video chat, literally a few seconds, and then go back to Car Chronicles. And so, after that, I get up at about 8 or 9. I mean, after that, Car Chronicles is still going between 8:30, 8:45. After Car Chronicles, get up, shower, get dressed, whatever. Get my stuff prepped or whatever. Get to my area. Prep. Pull stuff together. So glad. Radio stations, if you're listening, even flagship station in the Bahamas, listen. The last day of the record, the last recording day of the fourth season, I was so blessed with a brand new laptop. Oh, good God today. But anyway, if I would have had that trash can over there, man. But anyway, I get my stuff. Start going through. Now this time I'm pulling new stuff and prior to, you know, the night before, see if anything happened over the night and, you know, news reports and like I said, look, I ain't gonna be too deep. I'll let y'all know, Holy Spirit is one of my executive producers. If I need to change some stuff from what I told y'all the night before and to this morning, and if anything pop up this morning or whatever, and, you know, if I need to elaborate on some stuff that Apostle Jamila spoke on, or something that encouraged me to share with you all, that what she said or whatever, you know, this, that, and the third, or, you know, whatever, or something that my pastor has said or whatever, or, you know, just some encouraging words or whatever, that may be the whole broadcast, you know, whatever, and or some music that I've heard or share with you all, you know, this, it's, you know, that's from 8:45 a.m. until about 9:30 a.m. is my focus time of, okay, I need to make sure that I got stuff solid. You know. And then between 9:45 until about 11, I need to go ahead and start making sure that I got stuff down, packed, whatever. By 12:30, stuff needs to be in place, done, whatever. That's how it was on yesterday. But by the time I got, you know, by the time 2 o'clock hit, everything was a wrap. I was done, got up, left, it was over. That's my whole day, you know, whatever. I totally forgot about podcast platform. I totally forgot about, you know, even those affiliates that get the pre-recording. Those affiliates that don't get the live show, they get pre-recordings or whatever. I forgot to send those. until this morning. Because I got up, lifted my laptop, the email was still sitting right there in front of me. I was like, oh, and then I didn't, and even the times that I do come on, I support those stations by listening to myself all over again. I didn't even do that yesterday. Oh, y'all, your boy was exhausted. I was good on air. I was good. Y'all, when I tell y'all the Lord had me, listen. I'm going to tell y'all how exhausted I was. When I got off, I got in the bed about 2:45. Your boy didn't get out of the bed until about 5:30. I was whoa out. For real. I was whoa plum out. Some of y'all know why. Some of y'all don't. But I was whoa out. Whoa out. And even at 5:30 when I got up, I did not even, my mom was like, mm-mm. It was just, my mind wasn't even thinking about, you know, no other affiliates, like listening to the stations to see if I came on or not. It was just, my mind was just blank, and I just laid there. I got up about 5:30, and then I just laid there, and I got out of bed at least about 6:15, and I cooked supper. I had a late supper. Some of y'all saw that on Snapchat. Oh, gosh, that so good. I had some beef short ribs, and because I had took that out to make that for Sunday, and I'm going to tell y'all about that in a minute. About the cooking and whatnot, but because somebody had asked about that, I had that out for Sunday, but I know I had a business meeting on Sunday. Well, I forgot I had a business meeting on Sunday. The business meeting didn't get finalized until mid Sunday, and so I had already took my meat out Saturday night. Those cooks, you know, you have to take your meat out or whatever if you don't cook it the night before. So I'm glad I didn't cook it, because if I didn't, I would have told them, look, I got food at home. If I go to this meeting, I'm just getting something to drink or just a small appetizer, you know, to hold me over. Or I still would have ate, because the business meeting wasn't until 5 o'clock, and I didn't get home from church until about, 11:30 that morning. Because we still social distancing and the services are still condensed or what have you. But cook beef short ribs and some rice. I too much don't like vegetables, but hey, I still try to get it in. But I cooked dinner late last night. Then I had that while I was watching the game. That was my day. That was my day yesterday. And so, hey, I'm good. I'm good today. I was good this morning. Felt a little lethargic this morning, but I'm good now. After y'all stay grilling me on how y'all want me, and I was like, okay, you know what? These are my people. I cannot let these folks down. I got to give it to them real raw, straight to the point. I got to, you know, be enthused when I come on air, because they looking for this. And this is what I love to do for the people I love. You, my co-host. And so, look, when I come on here, know that I'm going to give it to y'all real raw, straight to the point. No chaser, all right? None. Bam! Come on, y'all. Let's rock it out on today. This is your boy Red. I'm the host of the IH3 show. If you all just now tuning in about, you know, few minutes after the hour. But we got a great show planned for you on today. We got a little bit of Inside Scoop with Red News. And we also got a Real Talk with Red discussion on today, and I'll tell you all about that in just a minute, because I have that. Let me tell y'all, hold on a second. Hold on a minute. I'm going to tell y'all in just a minute, because I have it saved in my Instagram thing. And I was like, okay, hold on a minute. All right, I got you. We can have a good conversation on this. And it is an elephant in a room type discussion. A real man. Real men understands that sex is not everything when it comes to satisfying a lady. Oh boy, your boy got this in the bag. And it's not, when I tell y'all this, fellas, it is not a trick in our bag to use this to get the sex. It's not. Put it like this. Let me add this word. Real, genuine men. Alright? You gonna want to hear this. Alright? You're going to want to hear this. So, coming up next is Nina Taylor with This Week in Gospel News. And then after that, I'm going to discuss, I got something to, discuss about, Ray J. Well, I'll just mention that right now because, you know, we're talking at our table. Ray J and, Princess Love. Ray J and Princess Love, well, Ray J filed for divorce, from Princess Love. And so, hold on and get, hold on one second. It popped up on me while I was, prepping this morning. And let me see if I can find it. Let me, in less than 2 months. Hold on one second. And I'm going to read this, and then we're going to go into, you know what, go ahead and do the intro for the Inside Scoop, and then Nina Taylor going to come in, all right? Got to catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop with Rufus. Right here on the RH3 Show. And so, okay, it is the Inside Scoop with Red segment, and this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on world and entertainment news. And then Nina Taylor also is here as well for her gospel news. And I have some, and after Nina, you know, it's going to be a commercial break, and I may come back with, you know, just a few more. But Ray J files for divorce from Princess Love after 4 years of marriage. The singer is asking for joint custody of their two children, 7-month-old Epic and 2-year-old daughter Melody. And this was all reported on yesterday. And so Ray J files, and this is all according to thegrio.com. Ray J files for divorce from wife Princess Love less than 2 months after she asked a court to dismiss her own filing to end her marriage. Oh, I didn't even know that. That was cold, Ray. Ooh. The couple tied a knot in 2016, and the parents of 9-month-old Epic Ray and 2-year-old daughter Melody Love. Ray J is asking for joint custody of the children, People reports. Love officially filed for divorce in May, 6 months after she publicly stated that her husband left her and their daughter alone in Vegas after an argument. The Love and Hip Hop star was pregnant with Epic at the time. Commercial break. Wait a minute. Hold on. Oh, I thought I had saw something. Commercial break. Then. Sorry about that. It's a real show. It's live. We're live. Sorry about that. Coming up next is Nina Taylor with This Week in Gospel News. And then after that, we got a Real Talk with Rufus discussion, where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on real life topics. We have grown folks discussion. Don't forget, y'all. Hey, we're not here to judge, but it's all from a Christian male perspective. Not all Christian male, but just mine. And I hope you like it. Hey, but you can still sound off. You can still sound off. You can still sound off. And I'll let y'all know that. Soon coming up next is Nina Taylor with This Week in Gospel News. Be back with more. All right.
Keep it where you got it. The Gospel News with Nina is coming up next right here on the RH3 Show.
Want to know more about something that you've seen or heard on the show, or you want to follow us, or more information about the broadcast, please visit our website at therh3show.com. It's the beginning of the fifth season right here on the RH3 Show, and a lot has already happened. I already told you during the Kitchen Table Talk, Inside Scoop with Rufus segment, Ask Rufus Letter, as well as the Real Talk with Rufus segment. Expect the unexpected, alright? It's an open door season.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit the RH3Show.com.
Jesus loving you. It sounds crazy, don't it?
Hey, this is Quayle.
This is Isaiah Templeton.
Hey, family, this is Darius Parker.
I'm Nina Taylor from The Gospel News.
Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Mario J. Brown.
Well, this is Rock River alongside Red.
This is Wendy.
You are listening to my boy Red with the RH3 Show.
And you're listening to 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 the RH3 Show.
Boss of boss. Oh, yes.
Let me tell you what it does.
Here is another Be Positive moment for today. Here's a quote by Hugh Hefner. It says, life is too short to be living someone else's dream. And I also heard a giant in the faith of mine, someone who's really strong and powerful in the word of God, says that you cannot be blessed by living someone else's anointing. To explain that, if God blessed you with something, you cannot be envious or wanting to get somebody else's stuff and choose that over yours. You cannot be blessed by somebody else's anointing. Give it biblical, like the fight with David and Goliath. Saul wanted David to wear his garment. I don't think David would have won that fight with Saul's garment. And so you know what? You cannot win a battle with somebody else's anointing. Worry about what God has blessed you with, and you will prosper, and you will remain victorious. Here is a flashback moment, a flashback piece of the RH3 Show. You know, using a therapist work. Some people say, well, no, you don't need no therapist. You a Christian, and you saved or whatever. Yes, you do. Quit telling people you don't need no therapist. Of course we, of, and I'm not knocking that. I'll be the first to tell you to seek God first. Lord, I'm calling on you, and I believe on the power and the blood of Jesus to help me. I believe on the power and the blood of Jesus to save me. Of course, I'm standing on your word for all of that to be delivered from depression. All of that can happen within an instant. I believe that wholeheartedly. I believe it can happen. Miraculous thing can happen right where you stand. Right where you stand in that area. But you can also know that there is an enemy, there's an adversary, there's a devil out here that knows your weaknesses and knows where you are weak at and knows where that can trigger and bring back that spirit of depression. By all means, when that happens, or if that should happen, pray. Seek God. Go to scripture. But I also say, Lord, while I'm praying and seeking and depending on you, Lord, I need guidance. I need people, not only my ministers at church, not only people around me, but I also need, you know, and you can, there's also out here counselors and guidance counselors and you know, guidance counselors, also, you know, people, what they call them, life coaches that are faith-based, you know, Christians or whatever. And I know a lot. Hit me up in my inbox, email me rh3show@gmail.com, and I'll give you 2 or 3, 4 maybe to help you. But faith-based life coaches that will help you walk with you, you know? But don't do it alone. That's the main thing. Go to God. Seek God. And get help. As I say at the end of each broadcast, know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and love beyond words. Join the RH3 Show family. For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit my website at TheRH3Show.com.
Hi, everybody. I'm Nina Taylor, and here is your gospel news. Worship leader and recording artist, singer, songwriter, and producer Israel Halton. He became involved full-time in worship ministry in 1989. From the start, he looked to overcome cultural and denominational barriers. With this idea as a centerpiece, Israel formed his New Breed Ministries in 1995 with his wife and a group of world-class musicians and singers. Touring extensively brought the ministry's powerful and diverse sound to churches around the U.S., while Israel's two 1997 releases, Whisper It Out Loud and Way of the World, kicked off his recording career. New Season from 2001 became the first Israel and New Breed release and their release on Sony. The label also issued Real in 2002 and Live from Another Level in 2004. Alive in South Africa in 2005 featured a performance in Cape Town, South Africa in front of more than 8,000 attendees. The holiday album, Timeless Christmas, appeared a year later, followed by Love God, Love People, the London Sessions in 2010. In 2012, he issued Decade, the double CD set. Halton and his group continued to document their travels with Covered, Alive in Asia, released in 2015. Singer, songwriter, and recording artist and pastor, director Wes Morgan, took the long and hard road in finding his calling in life. The son of pastors Joseph and Yolanda Morgan, Morgan spent his childhood traveling and singing gospel with his parents and his siblings. At the young age of 10, though, he began using drugs and drinking, which led to several jail sentences and a whole lot of time in recovery centers before he finally emerged from his cycle of substance abuse. Helping others who had unfortunately taken the same path, Morgan's mission in life eventually became the Reprieve Foundation, a nonprofit organization focused on drug and alcohol prevention and recovery. He also founded Bowtie World Music, a music and film production company. Morgan's debut album, Look at Me Now, was released in 2007 and was quickly embraced by the Christian and gospel communities, allowing him to tour and promote his foundation and mission. A second album, Under an Open Heaven, appeared in 2010. This year has been unprecedented in so many ways. One way that will not soon be forgotten is virtual learning. Kids at at home this fall 2020. Here's a few tips for surviving virtual learning during the COVID-19 era. Number one, keep a routine. This is a time-tested remedy for getting through uncertain times. It's true that children thrive with routine. This extends beyond learning to things like having the same menu planned for certain nights, the same bath shower nights, and the same bedtime and cuddle time. Part of keeping your routine is creating new routines for this time. Number two, talk openly with your children about their concerns regarding e-learning. Many of us are doing our best to shield our children from all the happenings in the world, but it is important to check in with them about their feelings and concerns regularly and provide a lot of comfort simply by listening and validating them. Three, create a designated learning space. One of the biggest challenges about e-learning is trying to find space for this activity, a room where your child can be comfortable and engage in learning with as little distractions as possible. Four, get outside every day. Now it's more important than ever to incorporate physical activity and fresh air into our day. And number five, hone your flexibility. The virus is teaching us all a valuable lesson on going with the flow and letting go. These are hard lessons for all of us and such a great time to model this for our children. If your child is experiencing challenges, the result of pandemic or otherwise, please seek out a healthcare provider and discuss your concern. Here's your blazing hot praise, top 10 gospel songs. Number 10, Jonathan McReynolds and Mally Music with Moving On. Number 9, Titus Showers featuring Jermaine Dolly, It's Gonna Be All Right. Number 8, Todd Delaney, Psalms 18, I Will Call on the Name. Number 7, PJ Morton, Leandria Johnson, and Mary Mary, All in His Plan. Number 6, Ricky Dillard featuring Tiff Joy. Number 5, Demetrius West and Jesus Promoters, I'm Next. Number 4, Keila Richardson, So Good. 3, Kiara Sheard, It Keeps Happening. Number 2, Ty Tribbett, We Gonna Be All Right. And our new number 1 song for this week comes from Ja'Kalen Carr, Changing Your Story. Well, that's your blazing hot praise, top 10 gospel songs, your tips for surviving e-learning during a pandemic, and your gospel news. I'm Nina Taylor, reminding you to go to my website at msninataylor.com. Now, let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
All right, you guys, I am back. Listen, I meant to say that, earlier, when I was talking about cooking the supper, one of my YouTube subscribers had asked me about my cooking with soul. And so I'm like, okay, that has to come back. And so, y'all, I'm about to start. As soon as I get me a good camera and, you know, good equipment to do that, once I start cooking supper or whatever and getting a lot of material together, I'm gonna start doing that. I'm gonna start uploading them on Sundays, and then they're gonna be a part of the RH3 show broadcast, meaning that Sunday through Friday is going to be the RH3 show broadcast. And so, excuse me, and also, I am preparing a special, an RH3 show special. It was an episode, during the fourth season that I recorded on, my phone, and this also includes a Cooking with Soul segment, on there, and so I'm trying to tweak that, trying to, you know, get some rest, and so, edit that all together, or whatever, and put that, so I may drop that one day this week, preferably, it looks like it's going to be, if not, I know not today. It's not going to be today. If I get some rest, because I got to do my jewelry consultant later on today. But I know that. But not today. But it's looking like Thursday or Friday. But if so, you'll see it, or whatever, and it's probably gonna be a full hour, between 30 minutes to an hour, or whatever. It's going to be a broadcast. It was recorded as I was on air. I did the broadcast. I pre-recorded the broadcast. I did it at home, and like behind the scenes or whatever. And then it's going to be my Cooking with Soul segment or whatever. You'll like it. You'll like it. But anyway, that's what I have for this part. It was something else. I just got through during that whole break or whatever, had gotten through eating lunch or whatever, and so I'm good. Coming up next, it is the Real Talk with Red discussion. Just going to take a little small, a few seconds commercial break. Be back with more of the RH3 show. All right. Want to connect with me and go beyond the broadcast? Do so by following me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at The RH3 Show. You can also watch us on YouTube, youtube.com/ I Rep a Savior. That's youtube.com/ IREPASAVIOR. Follow me on social media. Hi, it's The RH3 Show. Connect.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
This is real life. We show real love and we also have real conversations, all from a Christian male perspective. It's the Real Talk with Rufus right here on the RH3 Show. Yes, y'all, listen, with the RH3 show, all of it is real life. We show real love, we have real conversations. It is the Real Talk with Red, Real Talk with Rufus segment right here on the RH3 show. You all, on today, I'm tired. Nah. that's every day. That's every day. But, I just had lunch and I'm exhausted. I'm tired. Listen. I need not to do that again. Why? It's because I got the itis, and my people know what that is. Once you eat before air or afterwards, or once you eat before anything, oh, you out. My peoples, I love y'all. I love y'all. I love us. I love us. And oh, listen. What I'm gonna do, I'm going to produce this. I'm going to try to do it. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but I saw this on somebody else's page. But it's going to be a watch list of something that I'm watching. And maybe y'all could, you know, watch it with me or whatever. All right. How about that? How about that? Okay, so let's see. Let me pull up this here. Alright, here we go. Alright, it is the Real Talk with Rufus segment, and this is, let me get all professional and dignified. It is the Real Talk with Rufus segment. This is where I give you my honest, my unscripted opinion on real life topics. We also have grown folks. Let me be my real, my real self. This is where we give real life topics. We also have grown folks discussion. And on today, we're going to be talking about, look. As y'all know on the title, if y'all listening online or whatever, y'all see the title of the episode. And it is, it's not just all about sex, y'all. It really ain't. You know, some of us men is just real and genuine about it. And you know, of course, that's a gift and a reward, and of course that is one of the, you know, elements and one of the connections in a marriage or whatever, and in a relationship. But the things that we do is not, that's not some of our main focus. You feel me? And we do understand that. Ladies, don't think that every man that try to, you know, come and holler at you is for that. And like I always say, my opinion, comment, I give it to you all from a Christian male perspective. Okay, hold on one second. It all comes from a Christian male perspective. But like I was thinking, a man that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtain a favor. First, y'all hear me say this all the time. Like that scripture said, a man finds a wife, finds a good thing. He don't find a girlfriend from the beginning. He finds a wife. So, ladies, you got to see yourself as a wife from the get-go. You have to see yourself as a wife from the beginning. From the start, you got to see yourself as a wife. A man that finds a wife finds a good thing, and he obtain a favor. She is favor. Speaking of She Favor, She Favor 2020, SheFavor.org. Sponsored by Car Chronicles and Unity Church Charlotte. Host is Apostle Jamila Young Gooden and Apostle Fred Gooden. Anyway, a real man understands that sex is not everything when it comes to satisfying a lady. Number one, taking care of her. Making her happy. There is nothing more. And thank you, Holy Ghost, for bringing this back to my remembrance. Because I meant to clarify this on yesterday, and I think on Friday, when I said, and I just lost it again. Hot tonight. Taking care of her and making her happy. I said something and I wanted to clarify. Dang, it just slipped. It'll come back to me because the Lord brought it to me that quick. We gotta do what we can to make her happy. We got to do what we can, fellas, to be there for her and to, you know, satisfy her needs, be there for her, and make her happy. What was I talking about yesterday? It was on Friday. I know I was talking about a friend of mine, and then I was mentioning about you know, being there for her and whatever, and I also said that. I cleared it up on yesterday. It's gonna come to me. But yeah, fellas, you gotta do what you can to take care of her. You gotta do what you can to be there for her. You gotta do what you can to make sure she's happy. You gotta be there for her, and when you're doing that, you cannot lose yourself. In the midst of that, be there for her. Be her knight in shining armor. You know, satisfy her. Take care of her. Whenever, you know, I think it's coming to me. And it came from this. All of this is coming from something that I saw on Facebook yesterday. It was two texts, and I think it was just a demonstration. I doubt it was real. One of them was a text come from a girl and her boyfriend. And the other one comes from a text from a girl and her male best friend. The girl and her boyfriend, she staged it to where she was stranded, you know, and what should she do, this, that, and the third. And she was telling her boyfriend that she was stranded, that she was out checking the car, this, that, and the third. And her boyfriend was telling her, why did you get out, check the car, this, that, and the third. Call Uber, da-da-da-da-da, call insurance, something like that. It wasn't like, I'm on my way to come get you, stay in the car, you know, whatever, whatever, whatever. You'll be all right. Call a taxi. It was all of that. But her best friend, her male best friend, was a real gentleman out of the whole situation. Look, I'm on my way. I'm calling such and such. I'm about to be there to help you change the tire. And then I'm going to stop and get you something to eat on the way. Da-da-da-da-da. Taking real care of her. And fellas, that's what I'm... That's the prime example what I've always... And I try to instill in you all. And that I try to instill in you and try to tell you, look, do what you can to take care of your lady. Whether it be your girlfriend, whether it be your female best friend. And that's what I'm telling you. There's nothing wrong to ditch your brothers. And fellas may want to be upset with me when I say this. I don't care. There's nothing wrong to have female friends and just rock with them. Why? It's because them the ones that will bring the best out of you, for real, to make you even a better person. I feel, I'm the best me when I'm around my female friends, and that's no lie. No lie, I'm the best Red when I'm around my female friends. Just like today. My roadie, psych, and I always use this as an example. She's my 929, and I call my friends by their birthday. She's my 929, and so. And then also, I have three. My right hand, my left, and my heart. She's my heart. And my, well, it's three people that takes my heart. She's the middle, and my son is the right, and her son is the left. We're just good friends. Just good friends, you know. And she's one that I'm gonna be honest with you. Real raw, straight to the point. It's a real talk with Rufus segment, all right? She's the one I told you that, you know, I kind of had feelings for. But, hey, we just good friends. Just good friends. Good friends. Nothing, you know, whatever. Just good friends. And so, I respect that. And I see that what that is. But, nobody will rock with you and ride with you harder than your female friends. Really, the ones that's really locked like that. That, listen, take it from me. Take it from me. They'll take care of you more than, you know, whatever. Then, you know, hey. And then that right there will help you, honestly, with your relationship with your girlfriend, with your wife. For real. Long as they know, hey. I'm just saying. Number two, loving her scars. That's simple. That's cut and dry. Loving her scars. But, you know, hey. No matter what her scars are, it could be, you know, what she's have dealt with in the past to her her scars from family. I can have a whole broadcast, a whole hour, a whole 2 hours to tell you what I could pull out, different topics of scars, you know, dealing with female friends or whatever, what scars are. Scars could be hurt from friends. Scars could be hurt from parents. Scars could be hurt from children. Scars could be hurt from other friends. Scars could be hurt from boyfriends. Scars could be, and each one of those, you know, different topics, it could be, you know, subtrees under it, subtopics under it. Help her, loving her scars. Scars from her siblings. Help be there for her, and scars from her children's parents. I mean, her children's other parent or whatever. Look, help love her through her scars. She may talk to you and need your opinion and advice on this, that, and the third. Give it to her right and talk to her and calm her down and be there for her when you need her. That, whenever she's venting, those are scars that she needs help from, or scars that she needs you to talk to her, you know, talk to her and help her, you know, get the picture, help her, you know, reason with her on some stuff that she needs help on. Number three, scolding her when she doesn't take care of herself. Watch out! On this one is a good one, but watch out, because she can be upset, but she can also, in her upsetness and in her being angry and upset, she can be at a point to where she's very angry and she's not feeling it. But then she can, you know, blame you, but then she can come back and apologize and then see where you were trying to help. But tread this one lightly. But also, be there for her, but also let her handle her, but also watch her from a distance. But when you see her slip, grab her. Grab her. Talking her to 1 a.m. until she say, okay, I'll talk to you later. Or, all right, I'm finna go to bed. Then you say, okay, I'll talk to you later. Click. Then you fall asleep. Don't be the first one to fall asleep, because it'll be a wrap. Cook for her. Cook her food. Point blank period. She loves it. Or surprisingly buy her dinner. You know, whatever. Or drop money in her Cash App. Do whatever. Drop money in her Zelle. Drop money in her bank account. Whatever, you know. Look. Y'all fellas, y'all already know that. How the ladies are with food and whatever. Just take care of, do what you can. A real man understands that sex is not everything when it comes to satisfying the lady. Do what you can to satisfy and to please her. Alright? Alright. Listen, y'all. I enjoyed today's broadcast. Know that I love you for real. Know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, to love God, love yourself, and love other people. Beyond words, for more about your boy Red, the broadcast, any other affiliate station, what you've heard on the broadcast, hey, the RH3 show, our history, anything that you want to know about us, you can visit my website at therh3show.com. Other times that I air, you can visit that. It's on the front page. Subscribe to our newsletter, our quarterly news. Listen, I try to do it once a month or whatever. I try to do it three times a month, put it like that, but it all ended up being once a month. But anyway, I'm going to try to do one by the end of the week. And yeah, just subscribe to the newsletter and what have you. I love you all for real. And again, always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, to love God, love yourself, and love other people. Beyond words, for more about me or the broadcast, you can visit our website, like I said, at therh3show.com. I will talk to you all tomorrow, all right? I see you all. And I ain't gonna forget now. As soon as I get off, I'm going to stay here till I get my rest of my work done. Then I'm going to go and knock out. Tomorrow, y'all, listen, I had to think about it. Tomorrow, I have that procedure on tomorrow. So, last Friday's broadcast of my special guest will be tomorrow. I'm going to rest on tomorrow, and I'll see you all on Thursday. How about that? I have that procedure on tomorrow, that in-office procedure that I was telling y'all about. That had been rescheduled to tomorrow, so I'm going to rest up, and then I'll see you on Thursday, okay? Thursday may be a broadcast, best of broadcast, too, but you know what? I'll still let y'all know. You know, hey, follow me on social media. We may do an after show. Wednesday and Thursday, but I'll let y'all know via social media. Listen, you miss a day, you miss a lot, but also still follow me at the RH3 show. I'll talk to y'all tomorrow. All right, see you all. Peace.
See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night.